Economic development probably, as you guys have realized, has changed over the last couple of years. We're embracing that change. It's not all about smokestacks and chasing the large fish, shall we say. It's not. It's still about attracting business, but it's also about attracting people. And so we kind of have adopted that in the EDC, and we're working on that kind of hand in hand. We're not going to stop the traditional, but we're going to concentrate on the not so traditional. And I think we'll work very well with both TIF districts because you guys are doing that as well. You guys are developing areas not only for the community themselves, but also for further development down the road. So I look forward to working really hand in hand with you guys. One big project I know that obviously that has not only a wonderful opportunity, but is one that needs some marketing work is the Veterans Way project out there. I've been in contact with some of the building owners out there. I've been in contact with some of the some larger retailers. I can't say at this time, but know that there have been conversations there, and we have been focusing on it. The EDC is sending me to Nevada, to Las Vegas next week for that reason, to attend a retail convention there that was suggested to me by these larger retailers, two of whom which I have appointments with when I'm there. We needed to work, and the EDC, we needed to work on some of our marketing stuff, and this is not done, I will stress. There's still more I want to do with these things, with this, but this is just part of what we're putting together to take there. Particularly the front, there's some more I want to do to it. I will stress that it's not complete at the moment, but I plan to finish that up this evening. A lot of information about trade areas, 50-mile radius, 25-mile radius, just to give them a snapshot of Greensburg, Decatur County, and our region. And then if you open it up, it has a map of the entire area to showcase exactly how much land there is available, optimal land there, perfect visibility to I-74, and soon to have two entrance points have access to two clover leaves there. So, and that's why I was asking what time it was set for phase two to be done, because I'd like to be able to showcase that and tell them that, if you get it early, you'll be able to take advantage of phase two being completed. Take a look at that and let me know if there's anything. I've already found two errors in there. No, it's just a reference error, nothing big, but it's the largest retail convention, I've been told anyway, in the United States, so I'll be somewhat overwhelmed, but I feel this is the first time go through, you make your connections, so I've been lucky to have some conversations already with some commercial real estate firms, one of out of Cincinnati, sat down and spoke, and we'll be meeting again. As well as another, actually a real estate marketing firm that will do it, but trying to make the most of the trip. There's some other people from the region that's going to be there and plan to meet up. Maybe we can tag team some of these as well for the I-74 corridor as a whole. But really hoping to at least get the foot in the door. We have wonderful opportunities here in Greensburg and all along I-74, and we want to take advantage of that as much as possible for Decatur County. So. Again, I look forward to working with all of you. If any of you guys want to grab coffee or something, or have ideas, or want more information about what we're working on, I can tell you some of the initiatives we have at the EDC are to concentrate on housing, a great deal. And so far, 2008 is looking very nice for housing permits. I'm going to adjust some of those stats on the first page there, but we want to encourage builders. We want to encourage people to live here. I had a nice conversation with some lovely Honda employees yesterday. We sat around, had lunch, one of which lives here. The other ones all commute in. Got to talk about, what they think of Greensburg, they think of the area, what's important to them. So we're taking down all those notes and seeing if we can't, really implement some of those. They actually had some wonderful ideas, so I've already talked to Jeff at the Chamber, and I think we might try to implement some of those. And a lot of that is just getting connected to those new employees when they go through orientation. Make sure we get there and give them a presentation if we can, but at least some sort of information so they know what's in Greensburg, what's around Decatur County, so they're not just coming down here, working, and turning around and driving all the way back. But a little stuff like that that we're doing to really encourage people to live here in Greensburg and Decatur County and really kind of attract those families that will help our community grow and I guess be sustained. Luckily, Decatur County is one of the few rural communities, and I know I got to fill in the number in there on the front page, but we are projected to grow. A lot of rural communities in Indiana in particular are not, so we need to capitalize on that and maybe enhance it as much as possible. So, and with that, I'll take any questions. I know I'm rambling, but I'm excited to be here. I'm excited to work with you guys. I love my job. I have an administrative assistant hopefully coming in soon, which will make me love my job more, because that's what I do. I will apologize for the website. Our website right now is should be under construction. The talents of the administrative assistant that I'm hoping comes in, sit down and renovate that. It's some of the data is out of date, and in general, I'm not very pleased with it. So that's going to be renovated. And also, marketing materials such as this, I want to kind of really take off with that, so it's ready to go. If you guys are meeting with someone or you approached by someone, I want to be able to have that ready for you guys in a split second. I can send a PDF off to you, or what have you. So. That's an objective that we have.
I want to say thank you. I know we've tried and tried and tried and been looking for something in the marketing realm to market this in the NDC market in the past, and we've been told several things. So for you stepping up to the plate and getting something like this already, you know, ready to go and something that can be put out there, I'm impressed. I mean, this is great. This is
about three quarters baked, and this is just, you know, on the first go around that we. Administrative assistant, and I think with our marketing talents too, I think we can really put together some polished feature, capitalizing on some of the information here, but might not look exactly the same. So, and again, if you guys have any ideas or anything like that, or any
sell your soul for Target.
What's that?
Sell your soul and your firstborn for Target.
That is exactly what I was getting ready to say. I was like, find where they're staying and slip this underneath their doors.
Exactly, yeah.
Because I'm pretty sure that the committee plus one would spend time there.
I might have to, while I'm over there, I might have to give some phone calls and then just hold up my cell phone.
The committee plus one gets tired of driving to Columbus.
Yeah. But there are, on the back page of that, you can see, you know, the retail gap. That's essentially what the amount of money that we're leaving on the table. In those various categories, that's money that's essentially it's leakage. It's coming out of this area.
So retail gap.
Mm-hmm.
That's just not a term I'm familiar with. What does
it's essentially mean? What the actual sales are compared to what the estimated potential sales are, and it's and that difference is right there. That's what we leave on the table. That's the potential additional income. Again, it's all projections. That's a potential income.
So is that because of the lack of those particular businesses?
Could be. I mean, there's no one. That would be the argument that I would make to them. It's because people drive to Target. You know, people drive outside the community because they can't get the particular things here.
Correct.
And not grocery stores. You can see it's up there. Sometimes it's the type of businesses here. Sometimes it's just that they're not here at all. So those are the arguments that I'll be making to various entities when they come through. But
you're an excellent guy. Has there been thought given to also working with somebody that specializes in attracting retailers?
Oh, and that they'll be there too. And actually, I have a meeting with two of those. Billing costs can go pretty high, but yeah, I know I definitely have my length as far as and these people have connections and stuff and know people, so I'm hoping to break into that a little bit somehow and see what I can do. But there might be a need for that outside.
Yeah, I think I would echo what Adam said. From councilman, you know, to see somebody come in with a marketing strategy with a lot of different components for that product, for that development. Would be very welcome.
Oh, appreciate it. Appreciate it. Look forward to working up with all you guys.
Any updates on the industrial park?
On the
Officer Honda.
Okay, oh, the Business Enterprise Park, actually, oddly enough, I'm gonna probably make another one of these for that as well, just in case that happens. But I did submit it for two different projects from the state, and haven't heard back yet. But I was able to acquire a billboard courtesy of the Hospital Foundation Gala that I plan to help advertise on that side if we can and other sites. So I want to get the website up and more efficient, more effective, shall I say, before I put that billboard up there. What to do. Adam Trail Park, we got a visit from an outside business, haven't heard back yet. That might have fallen through, but it's always nice to have Nibbles. Working with the TIF board now, to the county TIF, to get utilities to the Business Enterprise Park there across from Honda, as well as expand internet in the entire area there. So high speed, because actually Adam Thrill Park does not have high speed internet there. And that's another one of our initiatives, is actually to see how we can help expand broadband throughout Decatur County, because currently Decatur County's rural population is the highest population without broadband in southeastern Indiana. So we want to change that.
Interesting.
Yeah, especially with all the schools going one to one. You have a kid going home that has no access to high speed broadband, and you're putting him or her at a loss compared to other ones. It's no longer amenity, it's a necessity, it's a utility. So we'll be seeking out all sorts of possibilities to kind of help bring up broadband as much as possible to the county.
One more question for me.
Sure.
Is there still any effort going on about trying to increase the availability of certain housing assets?
Yes, I mean, we do have a fair number of custom home builders, actually. Again, the housing permits are up in this quarter, 600% compared to the last 2 years, first quarters of the last 2 years. As far as the higher up sale of homes and such, I haven't really particularly focused on those. I could probably get that information for you. If you drive out on Park Road, you can see some sizable homes, some nice homes going there. I know, I believe a larger home builder actually just recently applied for additional lots, so we get some of those. Because our custom home construction folks are great, they're wonderful, but there's only so many that they can build at a time. We get these larger home builders in here taking an interest in Greensburg, that's good. I'll have to figure out exactly where the price of the home would be, but I have some of those that are going out behind Fairview. Find out for you as far as what the sale prices or how they've been moving.
Well, I wasn't so much interested in what they're selling for. I just know, from my understanding, there were certain price points that there was a deficit of those in the city.
Yeah, they haven't. That's something actually I can probably find for you to get precise. I hesitate to say, because I haven't concentrated right on that. That's something I can easily find. So. But that is a goal, to get that type of housing here, so we can retain some of the folks who can afford that housing.
Any other questions?
Thank you, Brian.
Yeah,
appreciate
thank you.
Appreciate you coming.
Next item on our agenda is approval of claims. We have four claims this evening. One from Umbaugh and Associates. for professional services related to tax increment financing for the state group three quarter allocation area. That vouchers for $2,525. There were two claims from Merrick Structure Point, one of $12,400 and one of $9,937. And then there's a voucher of $930 from Shawley's Land Survey. Those four claims altogether total up to $25,797. Our current balance is $657,512.31, so I would think we could afford to pay those out of that fund. We will be getting probably within a month our June distribution from county property taxes due last week. So I'd entertain a motion for us to pay our bills.
Motion.
I'm sorry, did you? Thanks, Judy. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you, Garrett. Motion made and seconded. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries 7-0.
I was hoping to have this opportunity to remind you that we should start seeing claims from our building, our contractor on Lincoln Street as early as next month.
Okay.
It's $1,000,001 over 5 months, so you know, on average, a couple hundred thousand a month. We do have $450,000 coming from the state. Don't know when we'll get that money, so we'll need to front whatever until we get that reimbursement. So over the next several months, I think you can expect to see a couple hundred thousand a month.
Okay.
Of which some will be reimbursed.
Okay, thank you. Our next meeting date is June 21st. I will not be in town that week. Adam, would you be able to conduct our meeting that week?
No problem.
Next meeting date would be June 21st, 2018 at 6:30 right here. With no other business to come before our board, I would seek a motion for adjournment.
So
thank you, Adam.
Okay.
Thank you, Judy. We will stand adjourned then. Thank you all for coming.